So the three major RNAs are mRNA, rRNA, and tRNA. Now the three of them are called as the major RNAs. Reason is that without the participation of these three RNAs, protein formation machinery would not be able to function. The very simple reason behind this is whenever the ribosomes are formed of rRNA. R stands here for ribosomal RNA. So without the presence of ribosomal RNA, ribosome formation will not be there because ribosomes are made up of rRNA and some special proteins. So if rRNA is not there, protein factory formation is not possible, and you know very well protein factories are ribosomes. So ribosome formation requires rRNA. Now the next one, messenger RNA. Whenever DNA has to cause the formation of proteins, now the information, which protein, and if you recollect your information of primary structure of the proteins, we have learned already, and many of you beautifully wrote in the assignments also, that the primary structure is controlled by genetic makeup. So DNA controls what will be the first amino acid, second amino acid, third amino acid, and how many amino acids will come in a particular sequence to form the chain which is called as the primary structure of protein. So how this information goes? It goes in the form of messenger RNA. So M stands for messenger. So DNA will prepare the messenger RNA which will carry the coded language or information of the amino acids to come. And those amino acids, that mean mRNA formation takes place in nucleus, and this mRNA is supposed to go outside, and then it will undergo the process of translation. So remember, whether it is RNA or rRNA or mRNA or tRNA, they all are formed inside the nucleus. So rRNA is formed inside the nucleus. But remember, it will be changed into ribosomal subunits, and these subunits are then released outside into cytoplasm, because ribosomes are protein factories and formation of protein always takes place outside the nucleus. Similarly, mRNA is also formed inside the nucleus, but it has to be shifted out because it has to carry the message for protein formation, and because ribosomal units are joined outside to form ribosomal factories or protein factories, so mRNA has to be shifted outside the nucleus to help in the formation of proteins. Now, in the same manner, we have tRNAs. Now, tRNAs are also are those RNAs which are also called as the transfer RNA. Now, why are they called transfer RNA? Because same way they are formed inside the nucleus, but they are shifted outside the nucleus once they are formed. And once they are shifted outside, their function is to carry amino acids. So whenever protein formation starts, tRNA will start picking up the amino acids, specific amino acids, and bring them in a particular sequence to form a chain, and the chain will develop peptide bonds, and finally the primary structure of protein would be ready. I hope this small introduction is clear to you. Remember, the three of them are single cell in nature. So when we think of the mRNA, let's start with the mRNA. mRNA, remember, will always remain linear. Don't expect any bending in the case of mRNA. So mRNA is a linear arrangement of amino acids. So its primary structure is controlled by the DNA, and then it does not undergo any twisting, no secondary coiling, nothing of such type. So messenger RNA is a long RNA which constitute 2 to 5%. So if you consider that there is 100% amount of RNA present, so out of 100, only 2 to 5% of total RNA of a cell is mRNA, and it brings the instruction from the DNA for the formation of a particular primary structure or the particular chain of amino acids. Therefore, it is called as genetic RNA also. It is also called as the information containing RNA. because it carries the information or the message. Now, remember that the message present on the RNA is in the form of codons. So we'll be learning about codon in the 12th class in detail. Actually, codon is nothing but a triplets of nitrogen bases. Triplets of nitrogen bases like AUG. A means adenine, U means uracil, G means guanine. So three of them joined together to form a codon. Now, what is the function of codon? You'll be understanding in detail in 12th class. So now the next main point is that the structure of the messenger RNA appears to be like this. So it will be a linear arrangement of the codons. It's a linear arrangement of codons. The first codon is always called as the start codon or initiation codon. That means whenever the protein formation has to start, messenger RNA carries the information from one end. So the end, which is the tip of the mRNA, is called as the 5 prime end, and the last end is called as the 3 prime end. Now, why 5 and 3? In the structure of DNA, I will clear this point to you. I don't want to do the repetitions again. So, one end of the RNA or messenger RNA, either these RNA also, one end is always called as the 5 prime end and the other end is called as the 3 prime end. Now, this is called as the tip, initial tip, and this is the last final tip. Now, the whole information is present in the form of codons. So, if this is the first codon, then all other codons will be present and this will be the last codon. So an mRNA will always start with the initiation codon and end with the termination. Termination means that this will be the last codon which will give the signal, now no more amino acids are required. So stop the attachment of more amino acid. So starting amino acid is controlled by initiation codon, and stoppage of this addition of amino acid to the primary structure is controlled by the termination codon.